It was 1860 when the movement began, a cultural phenomenon that would shape all of Europe and change the way we think about art forever. Of course, that movement is Impressionism, and I'm Thomas Kincaid, the painter of light. When I think about Impressionism, I think about the works of the great French Impressionist artists who challenged the presumption that art needed to be dark and detailed and hard-edged. When I was a young artist, just getting started, I began experimenting with the techniques of the Impressionist painters. I think the use of light of such masters as Claude Monet, Renoir, Sisley, and Pizarro influenced me immensely. Their ability to blend color, utilize dappled light, create moods of sunset and sunrise. The use of wet streets and misty mornings became a part of the visual vocabulary of the Impressionists, and I began to experiment with those same effects myself. As I contemplated exhibiting my Impressionist works, I desired to have complete creative freedom, so I began to utilize a brush name and to sign my signature completely different from the Thomas Kincaid signature of my more academic studio style. The name I chose for these paintings was Robert Girard. I liked it because it had a French sound to it, and yet each name had two syllables, just like Thomas Kincaid. I developed a signature for the Girard paintings and began to sign these Impressionist works with my new signature. One of the first paintings in the Robert Girard collection is Morning Stroll, which features an imaginary scene, perhaps along the Loire Valley, that region of France noted for those beautiful chateaus with the blue slate tile roofs. A couple strolls along the path beside the river, dressed in period attire. Light is pouring from the trees and enveloping the sky with a rosy sense of morning. As we dim the lights on Evening Stroll, you begin to see the effect of morning become dimmer, as though it were early, early morning before the sun is fully in the sky. As the light begins to come up, morning is dawning again and the light pours from the heavens. We spoke of dappled light, and of course this painting features dappled light all throughout the setting. You see light pouring from the trees and the trees casting shadows, but allowing those little pinpoints of light to show on the ground below. Another painting in the Girard collection is entitled The Cottage, and I'm very excited about this because this truly is one of the earliest examples of a cottage painting that I ever painted. This painting features broken color, the effect of laying strokes of paint side by side to create the desired effect. This imaginary setting features a whimsical cottage with spring blooms lining the walkway. I enjoyed painting the figures of the woman and the young girl. Now at this time, I of course had been married to Nanette only a few years, so she agreed to pose as both model for the woman and for her daughter. There were geese in the neighborhood park where we used to ride our bicycles, and so I managed to create the effect of geese walking along in the sunlight by studying the forms of the geese I saw every day at the park. As the lights come down on the cottage, we see the afternoon light begin to rake over the canvas. It's as though the evening is coming and the hues of nature begin to reflect that golden glow of sunset. As the lights begin to come back up, we see the daylight pouring forth from the heavens once more, reminding us that different effects of light on the painting create different moods altogether. The Robert Girard collection is a very rare group of paintings indeed. They are works from my archive that date back 15 years or more, and I'm very excited to be presenting them in printed form. This is Thomas Kincaid. Remember, the spirit of Impressionism still lives as together we share the light. God bless.